What's going on, YouTube? Welcome to Members Only. Now, this is the open discussion channel, so I will be sharing my opinions on all the topics that we talk about. And you guys can share your opinions and your thoughts in the comments. So if you're new, you know, hit that subscribe button, get the likes up, and let's get right into it. Now, tonight we're going to talk about Eazy-E, Tupac Shakur, two hip-hop legends. Now, and it seems like hip-hop is the only genre that you have to have protection. Like, you have to affiliate yourself with a clique or a group or a gang or any type of organization to have protection. Now, as a hip-hop artist, you will want to make as much money as possible without any issues. But, you know, that barely happens. You got guys from all over in different states that want to tax you, especially when you come to this city. Now, everybody know the saying checking in. Well, there's guys that take offense if you come to the city without checking in. And, you know, you got things that happen, you know, guys that want to target rappers for their jewelry, for their money. So the best practice is to check in. And it's not about being scared, it's all about being smart. You don't know what's going on in every city. So you want to affiliate yourself with with some good people to protect yourself, just to make sure everything's smooth. Now, almost every rapper have some type of affiliation with some guys on the streets, whether they grew up around them, whether they're their homeboys, or whether they just need protection, because you need to affiliate yourself with some just to make sure people stay off you. Now, Tupac always had homies around him. Like, in the East Coast, he had Live Squad around him. And then when he went to the West Coast, he did have MOB, which is the Bloods. And of course, you had Eazy-E. He had affiliation with the Southside Crips, and he had some type of affiliation with the Kelly Park Crips. So that tells you right there that you need to be affiliated with some type of group, you know, just to chill. Not a lot of people might say, why won't you just hire professional security instead of, you know, putting yourself in harm's way with your guys carrying your weapons and having your guys back you? Well, that ties into the budget. Security can cost a lot of money, especially if you're moving around from city to city day to day. It ties into the budget. So a lot of people would rather just have the men around them just to back them up. Now, extortion is really the easiest and quickest way to make money in the hip-hop genre. You have some guys that go into the clubs and end up getting a chain snatch, and that's really a extortion move just for you to pay a fee just to get it back. Now, with that happening, it can be very humiliating, and it can put a stain on your name. So once that happened to you, that can kind of damage your hip-hop career. So if that happened to you once, other people hearing about it from city to city, other people's going to try you. So you have to affiliate yourself with the right guys. It's all about standing next to the right people. People with the right reputation, so others know you're nothing to play with because you're standing right next to them. So that's just basically how the game goes. Now, as far as Tupac and Eazy-E, the first thing you might think when I say extortion, the first person that come up is Suge Knight. But no, Suge Knight doesn't have anything to do with what we're talking about tonight. According to FBI files, Eazy-E and Tupac were receiving threats by the same organization, which was the Jewish Defense League. Now, the Jewish Defense League is a far-right religious and political organization in the U.S. and Canada. Its stated goal is to protect Jews from anti-Semitism by whatever means necessary. Now, that's how some organizations start off, just like every gang start off as to protect their own kind. But, you know, some sources say that they turn into a militant strong-arm organization. That's when, as far as ripping off street dealers and extorting big shots for $50,000. Now, according to FBI files, Eazy-E has been receiving threats early as 1992. Around that time, Eazy was paying $1,000 a week to someone as a security consultant. So we don't know if that had anything to do with Suge Knight because they did have their issues, or it was the Jewish Defense League. Now, both big hip-hop stars would receive phone calls stating that, you know, call for a fee to prevent anything bad from happening. Now, we're not talking about a street gang that's doing these threats. We're talking about a militant, organized, strategic party, like a political party. So just imagine the Black Panthers extorting people. Even though we heard stories about the Black Panthers trying to extort Felix Mitchell out of Oakland. Now, Felix Mitchell was a big-time dealer that was getting a lot of money. But that's a different story. But anyway, the Jewish Defense League will be way more serious and way more dangerous than any street gang. So as far as these two big hip-hop stars, they would travel from city to city, state to state. Just imagine receiving phone calls from your hotel. It's like, how you know I'm here? Now, according to the FBI documents, these guys were extorting money from various rap music stars via threats. So they was already extorting other rappers. Now, they would contact the victims, and they would offer them protection for a fee. Now, I highly doubt that Eazy-E and Tupac would allow themselves to get extorted by this organization. They probably wasn't taking it very serious. Both guys had a lot going on during the time. Both guys were into it with different people. So, you know, the threats could have been coming from anywhere. Now, Eazy-E probably didn't have that much enemies, but Tupac, we all know how he got down, man. He had a lot of enemies, and he was into it with a lot of people. So, you know, during that time, he probably was already used to all those phone calls. It was times he couldn't even leave the crib without having a bulletproof vest, so. Now, the FBI didn't really get to see what all this was about due to Tupac and Eazy-E passing away. Now, with both men passing away within a short amount of time from each other, of course, the Jewish Defense League was under investigation. And I'm not going to sit up here and make up a big conspiracy. These are like public FBI records. You guys can look it up and you guys can share your opinions in the comments. Now, during the investigation, the FBI did go back and try to retrieve some files, but there was a couple of pages missing. I think they said it was about 3 pages missing. Now, I don't know what's that about, but it's looking like someone has some type of ties on the inside. Yeah, so there's a little tampering going on. But anyway, y'all let me know in the comments on what y'all think. Don't be a stranger, get involved. I appreciate all the support. If you're new, hit that like button. If you're new, subscribe to the channel. You already know you got to turn your notifications on so you don't miss out on the content. And you already know, man, we're going to give you all these type of videos every week. I appreciate all the support. And y'all can hit me up. Y'all got the email. Y'all got the Instagram. Everyone take care, man. And y'all be safe. I'm out. Thank you.